इन दिस वीडियो विल डिस्कस अबाउट राइट हैंड स्क्रू रूल. व्हाट इज राइट हैंड स्क्रू रूल? दिस इज योर स्क्रू एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड द हेड ऑफ द स्क्रू एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड द दिस इज द टॉप ऑफ द स्क्रू एंड यू होल्ड द स्क्रू बाय मीन्स ऑफ योर राइट हैंड एंड द कॉर्नर ऑफ योर फिंगर विल गिव यू द plane of rotation and the movement or motion of the tip of the screw will give you the direction of rotation. You see in this diagram that this is a screw and suppose there are two axes. I have taken two axes. This is suppose x axis and this is your y axis. And when the screw rotate in anticlockwise direction, you see the direction of rotation. If the screw rotate, that is the tip of the screw which is in the xy plane. If the tip rotates in anticlockwise direction, then the head of the screw will rotate in anticlockwise direction, then you see the tip will move along the z axis which is perpendicular to your xy plane. You see in this experiment I am rotating the screw in anticlockwise direction. You see, I am rotating the screw in anticlockwise direction and how the tip of the screw is moving. You see, when you rotate the screw by means of your right hand in anticlockwise direction, you see in which direction the tip is moving. You see, the tip is moving along z axis. Okay. So this is your plane of rotation. You see, this is your plane of rotation. If I take a paper, then I can show you the plane of rotation. This is your x axis. If this is your x axis, this is your y axis, and this is your z axis. If you take this is x axis, this is y axis, then this will be your z axis. And the plane of rotation is along the xy plane. You see, this is the xy plane of rotation and the movement of if the plane of rotation is in xy plane, then the direction of rotation will be along the z axis. You see in this experiment, if you take a clockwise rotation like this, okay, if you take a clockwise rotation like this, then what you will see? You will see there is a movement of the z axis in negative direction. The tip is moving in the negative z direction. You see, it will be negative z direction. So if a right handed screw is rotated in xy plane, you see in xy plane in anticlockwise direction, you see if it is rotated in anticlockwise direction, then it will move, the tip will move in positive z direction. And if it rotate in clockwise direction, you see, if you rotate it in clockwise direction like this, then which direction the tip is moving? It is in negative z direction. You see, it is going in this way, in the negative z direction. You can also show the cross product by using this right handed screw rule. Suppose you have two vectors, this is vector A and this is vector B. Then you have two angles. This is a smaller angle. You see, this is a smaller angle and this is a larger angle, bigger angle. Like suppose if this angle is 90 degree, if it is x axis, this is y axis, and if this angle is 90 degree, then this angle will be equal to 270 degree. And while taking the rotation, you should consider the smaller angle. Okay. That means if you rotate the screw in anticlockwise direction like this, you have to take the angle theta, this smaller angle, 90 degree, not 270 degree. So suppose you take the vector A and this is the vector B, and you take A cross B, that is equal to AB sin theta, then that theta is the smaller angle, this angle. And the direction of A cross B, you see, if you rotate like this, then the direction of A cross B, this will be in this direction, that is z direction. Similarly, in case of torque, if you take two vectors F and R, suppose this is the R vector and this is the force vector, and you draw this force vector here, okay, you draw the force vector here, and if this is the F vector and this is the R vector, then this will be the direction of the torque, tau. Right-handed screw rule is very important in rotational mechanics. You should practice this simple experiment in home. Thank you.